You don't allow any mining activity to go on within a band of 500 meters from the shores of the water bodies. And that is where we also get a problem. So most of our chiefs, they know that, oh, this place is a buffer zone. It is not granted to anybody. So you go to the rural area, they will say that this is the land for the chiefs. This is where the galamseys, both locals and the international galamseys, cash in to really destroy the water bodies.
In terms of environmental pollution, what worries many of us is the water bodies. Because many people still drink from these rivers. So if they are mining upstream, it's going downstream. Wherever they are doing the mining, most of these water bodies are now completely dead. I've seen several rivers and water bodies that now have no life, no fish, nothing. And the long-term effect, we may not be able to tell. But in some areas, the short-term effects are so visible that you will see that within a short period, there's a particular illness within a particular community because they went and drank the water. So now what is happening is that even the rural communities where they didn't have to buy water or bottled water, now most of them are buying, you know, bottled water, bottled and other sachet water because they are afraid to drink from the rivers and water bodies that they formerly would take freely from. There have been several research on the metallic content of rivers and water bodies, and they found that heavy metals are now on the increase. So the impact is enormous.
Mercury poisoning is a big concern. Even as I was growing up as a kid, I saw them roasting mercury. they call it roasting mercury. They put it in a pan, and you know, the smoke that come out. They do not wear nose masks, nothing. And they get exposed to these chemicals. I have had a relative of die from cancer. At that time, we didn't know it was due to mercury, but it was later when I had that exposure that I understood that probably they died from inhalation of mercury. Yeah, so it's a big problem. It's a huge problem. How does the mercury enter our system? It is supposed to be a banned substance, at least in mining. It is supposed to be banned. But how come we still have mercury in the system to the extent that they have easy access? My fear is that a lot of our water bodies, which are already polluted anyway, have also had this mercury contamination. And to think that Ghanaians love fresh fish, and most of these fresh fish are caught from these water bodies that have been contaminated, that is a very serious issue we are dealing with here. I believe if we did a thorough research and try to get the frequency of diseases, certain kinds of diseases in mining areas, we could draw that linkage between those diseases and then the prevalence of mercury and other heavy metals in our water bodies. Yeah.
My PhD research is in GIS and remote sensing. So specifically, the topic is to identify landscape elements implicated in Buruli, Osa, endemic regions of Ghana. When you come to Takwa, for example, we have a lot of large-scale mining companies here, but we don't have the disease here. When you move out of Takwa to other communities, like Amansia West District, Upper Dentura West District, we have these diseases there. And those are areas where we have a lot of these galamsey operators operating. And we found out that these places, the processes that they use to extract the minerals are crude. And nobody regulates them, the chemicals they use to extract the minerals, they are released into water bodies and into the soils, which later goes into the farming areas and the plants and the water that the communities drink. They get infected. They get infected by way of reducing their immune system. And then when anything touches them or they have any fracture, it grows into that, the Borrelia ulcer. So I found out that for areas that mining activities are not regulated, that is the areas where we have these diseases most.
Small-scale miners are taking over cocoa farms at a very rapid rate. We haven't done any research to establish the figures yet, but I guess it must be a very serious problem. Because increasingly we are seeing a lot of cocoa farmers giving up their farms to small-scale miners, and sometimes Chinese. They come and they buy the land very cheaply and they destroy the cocoa farms and then do their mining. So I believe in the next few years, if we were to do some serious research, it will be able to establish that fact that yes, cocoa production will be affected because of the increase in small-scale mining.
Na sɛ ba sɛ yɛhu sɛ gold no wɔ ha ne sɛ ɔno kɔ nana hɔ ne ɔkɔ chief hɔ na sɛ wode land ba mu a ne yɛka land ho asɛ na wopɛ ne yɛfɛ mu bat wɔmpɛ deɛ a sane sɛ ɛdwu baabi a sika ntɛm no deɛ ɛyɛ ɛnyɛ adwasabɔ sɛ ade no wɔmɛnti wɔ hɔ a ɛbɛ last. Idea I him for Pina or now, ye ban said, Sir, your tongue was as a message at a little for. Ain't you in town, sir? You said, you know, much nothing. Now, Mokan, no mind you, you know, and son. But with that, the repatriate, but the German's as a friend, I would send him to court.
I would use the Kenya enclave as an example. Food security has become a big issue there. Because most farmers have lost their land. These have been taken up as concessions. And they don't allow you, they would give you some time to leave the place, especially where they're going to mine. And if about 100 farmers lose their farms, what do you think the implications are for the families themselves and for those who buy food? So food security is a big question when it comes to mining. And I would say that in Kenya, as soon as you have mining coming into a place, cost of living also suddenly jumps up. And for the local people, it is food. So if I have to spend much more money to buy food, then food security becomes, you know, an issue. So food security and mining is a big question. And I think more and more, food security will become a problem if we are not careful the way mining is being done in the country.
So far, I'm yet to see an abandoned small-scale mining land that has been reverted to agricultural land. I'm yet to see one. It's because of the chemicals they use and the nature of the land disturbance. They use these heavy equipments that bring up the part of the soil that is not needed. They dig deep, bring it up, and then basically it's mud. That makes its usage as agricultural land very, very difficult. We need to plant leguminous crops and trees like teaks and other stuff to make it more fertile before it can be used for, you know, agriculture. But unfortunately, again, we come back to Minerals Commission and their oversight role over the sector. Nobody is asking them to do so. So they leave and then they leave the huge pits, which gather water. Mosquitoes come in, create malaria is all over the place and all that. So it's a mess.